this lecture on the topic called Policy Planning and Institutions for Disaster Mitigation, which is a topic from the subject called Disaster Management. Before going deep into the subject matter, let me first give you some specific instructional objectives that we are going to cover in this particular lecture. The first one is we shall define disaster. So probably by this time you all are acquainted with the term disaster, but before delving into the deeper concepts of the policies on disaster management, I will first of all formally define the word disaster. Next, we'll understand the principles of disaster management cycle and how this disaster management cycle is used by the policy makers for framing different policies related to disaster risk reduction. So coming to this slide, which is on what is disaster. So the first definition, you can look at the first definition. This tells that disaster is a sudden accident or a natural catastrophe that causes great damage or loss of life and property. So you can see the term sudden accident. Sudden accident means like earthquake. Earthquake is a natural hazard which comes without any warning. Therefore, it is an example of sudden accident. A natural catastrophe, any catastrophe which has its origin like from the nature and it causes great damage or loss of life, livelihood, property and assets. So this is a very plain and simple definition which is for the understanding of a layman. But going to the definition as proposed by UNISDR, which is the United Nations International Strategy for Disaster Reduction, so it gives a formal definition for disaster. Now, disaster is a serious disruption of functioning of a community or society involving widespread human, material, economic, environmental losses and impacts which exceeds the ability of the affected community or society to cope using its own resources. So you can see a lot of things have been mentioned in this definition. So first of all, now you see the community. Whenever a natural disaster happens, it strikes a particular community or a society. So, and these are the components of the community or the society, like human beings, they live in that community. Then we have the materials or the assets of that community. Then obviously a community has its own economy. And nevertheless, we have the environmental aspect of that community also. So when the disaster strikes, it will strike all these four aspects or these four components of the community. Now coming to the next slide. Now disaster and its types. I hope you also have read about the disaster and its type, but still I am going to explain it once more. So disaster is categorized broadly into three categories, like the endogenic one, exogenic, climatic and land use change. So what do you mean by endogenic? Endogenic disasters are the ones that have its origin below the surface of the earth. Endogenic means something that is generated or originated below the surface of the earth, like volcano and earthquake. These are some of the examples of natural disasters which are triggered below the surface of the earth. Then we have the exogenic natural disasters which are triggered on the surface of the earth, like floods, karst collapse, snow avalanche, mass movement, tsunami, coastal erosion. You must have read about the onset, how they are going to affect the community and what are the steps that we are taking to mitigate these disasters. You have read in the previous module. Now there are certain disasters which are linked to climate change and change in land use pattern. They are desertification, permafrost degradation, floods and salinity. What do you mean by land use change? Now you see, a particular land is distributed for different purposes. It doesn't happen that a particular land is used for only a specific purpose. It never happens in that way. A particular land can be used for different purposes, like some of the portion of that land is used for residential purpose, some of the portion of that land is used for commercial purpose, a portion of that is used as forest cover, and so on and so forth. So if you change the land use pattern, definitely it is going to trigger some kind of natural disaster or natural calamity. Coming to the next slide, so you can see the photo. This photo is from the 2001 Bhuj earthquake, which occurred in Gujarat and its magnitude was around 7.7. Coming to the next photo, this is the 2004 Andaman Sumatra earthquake, which triggered a tsunami, and you can see this entire place has been engulfed with the seawater, and you can see how these debris and this car, they are floating in the sea waters. Now coming to the next photo, this is the 1999 super cyclone that occurred in Odisha. You can see how that particular cyclone has completely destroyed the place. And last but not the least, this is the 2018 Kerala floods, which was considered as the most worst flood in the history of Kerala. Now coming to the disaster management cycle, so let us look at the definition of disaster management cycle. Disaster management cycle illustrates the ongoing process by which governments, business and civil society plan for and reduce the impact of disasters, react during and immediately following a disaster, and take steps to recover after a disaster has occurred. So in simple terms, it is telling that what are the steps that we are taking to prevent or to reduce the risk of a disaster, and after the disaster has occurred, what are the steps or the recovery measures that we are taking to cope up with that disaster. So this is the simple definition of disaster management cycle. Now you can see that this is a multi-stage cyclic concept. Multi-stage means it has got four stages in it. Like we have the mitigation, preparedness, response, recovery, four stages or the four phases of the disaster management cycle, and it is a concept. So it is not a reality, this is simply a concept. Now let us discuss about each phase or each component of this cycle in detail. So the first phase or the first stage is the mitigation phase. So this is the first phase of the cycle. So looking at the definition of mitigation means taking sustained actions to reduce or eliminate long-term risk to people and property from hazards and their effects. So looking at the word mitigate means to lessen the severity. So whenever a disaster occurs or whenever a natural calamity occurs at a particular place, so definitely there will be some loss of life, some loss of property and livelihood and many other things, but there will be definitely some loss, but we cannot neglect that loss, but we can reduce the losses. So that is nothing but mitigation, reducing the loss. So and these are the various aspects of this mitigation phase, like risk identification. Before a calamity strikes at a particular place, we should identify the potential risks of that area and of that natural disaster. Then comes the risk analysis. We should analyze the risk in detail. Then land use planning, about which I have already told in detail. Now technical prevention, how the technology is used to prevent these natural disasters. And lastly, the capacity building. Capacity building means there are different institutions and organizations that have been created by the government at various levels, like at the national, the state, district, and not to forget at the block level even. So our main aim should be these organizations or these institutions that have been created to fight any kind of natural disaster, we have to increase their efficiency. So that is called as capacity building. Now coming to the next phase, that is the preparedness. Preparedness in simple terms means how much we are prepared, how well prepared we are. So like for example, my dear students, when you are going to an exam, if you are not prepared at all, if you are not well prepared, then obviously you are not going to score good marks in your exam. In the same way, we are all prone to natural disaster. Our mother earth, our country, is also prone to natural disaster. So if our government, if our community, if our society is not prepared to tackle the ill consequences of these disasters, then definitely the losses will be very much high. So preparedness means building the emergency management function to respond effectively to and recover from any hazard. This is very simple. And in the same way, it has got various aspects like evaluation of the risk, emergency exercises and training. So you have seen that various organizations, they conduct mock drill and they kind of spread awareness among the members of the community regarding various kinds of natural disasters. And warning systems, now these days we are using various advanced warning systems, that is why we are able to minimize the losses. in various disasters. Now coming to the next slide, that is the response phase. Now it is a common perception among the people that whenever response is always after a disaster strikes. No, response can be before, during and after a disaster. So if a particular disaster is striking a place, then we can respond prior to that or during that disaster or after that disaster. And why we should respond effectively? Because it has been seen that by responding effectively, we can save a lot of lives, we can save the livelihood of the people, and not to forget the property losses or the asset losses. Now coming to the last or the fourth phase of the disaster management cycle, that's the recovery. Recovery means rebuilding communities so that individuals, businesses and governments can function on their own, return to normal life and protect against future hazards. So what do you mean by recovery? So you see, my dear students, whenever a particular natural disaster it strikes a place, so obviously there will be some losses, there will be collapse of many buildings, many structures, all these come under economic losses. So recovery means how efficiently we are recovering from that. So we should be able to adapt ourselves to these bad consequences of this natural disaster, and we should recover as soon as possible so that it will not hamper or affect the development prospect of our country. Now these are recovery in simple terms means restoring normalcy, restoring a normal life. So before a disaster, before that disaster we are leading a normal life, and how after that disaster also we are trying to lead a normal life, that is the simple definition of recovery. And these are some of the aspects of recovery, that is damage assessment. Rehabilitation means that is relocating the affected people from that affected region to a safer place, providing them all sorts of amenities like food, shelter, medical help and other such amenities. And reconstruction means whatever buildings or structures they have collapsed or have been affected, we have to reconstruct those things. Now policy. So you see, policy is made by government in response to some sort of issue or problem that requires solution. So whenever there is a problem, so to counteract that problem we have to build some kind of policies. So that is what government is doing. So government is framing or formulating various types of policies, and there are some major institutions or organizations that are formed by government to combat disaster. These are some of the organizations that have been created by the government, like we have the National Disaster Management Authority, in short NDMA, National Platform for Disaster Risk Reduction NPDRR, National Institute for Disaster Management NIDM, National Crisis Management Committee NCMC, National Executive Committee NEC, National Disaster Response Force NDRF. I will discuss about all these organizations or institutions in detail in a separate lecture video. Now we have already seen that these policies are framed by our policymakers or the people at who are forming the government. Now what should be the focus area of these policymakers? So on what things our policymakers should focus before making any policy. So first thing is making disaster risk reduction or development priority. So I said that if a disaster strikes, then it will definitely affect the developmental pace of our country. So any developmental work that is going on gets affected. So our main aim is that the disaster risk reduction should be incorporated or should be integrated within the development agenda of that particular place of that particular country. Now coming to the second point, to enhance institutional capacity in disaster risk reduction. This I have already discussed, like various institutions, organizations, they are present at various levels, national, state, district, and the government should aim at increasing the efficiency of these institutions or organizations. Now coming to the next slide, to develop national platforms for disaster risk reduction. So what government is doing nowadays, you can see NPDRR, National Platform for Disaster Risk Reduction. It is a platform which was created in 2013, and many other countries in the world, they have also created similar platform. And you can see that the aim of the particular aim of this platform is to bring all people, all organization, all social groups under one umbrella. You can see in this figure, if this is the platform, we have government, we have people from industries, we have people from media houses, the scientific community, then we have people, eminent persons from outside India. So they all are brought onto this platform so that they can share their views and try to form something by which we can tackle the disaster. Now coming to the fourth point, that is improving early warning systems. So these days, with the help of technological advancement, we are able to monitor various disasters very effectively. Like we are using the satellite based remote sensing in drought monitoring. So to monitor drought, we are using the satellite based technology, and we are also using the satellite based technology to track and monitor the cyclones. That is why even if our state Odisha is getting affected every year by various cyclones, but still we are able to negate its effect through the use of satellite based technologies and application of GPS to monitor the movement of tectonic plates at plate boundaries. So the various premier institutes of our country, like the IITs, they are using this the GPS technology to monitor this plate movement so that any earthquake, any possible earthquake, can be predicted at advance. Now coming to the fifth point, that's the effective disaster response through disaster preparedness. Preparedness, I've already told you what do you mean by disaster preparedness. So if you are saying that this particular disaster is going to strike this place, then beforehand we have to disseminate the information among the people through various means, like we can use the print media, electronic media, through internet. So these are the various ways through which the information can be passed on to the people. Now we should involve the community in the fight against disasters, and we should ensure safety. First of all, the main priority of the government is to ensure safety of the people. There should not be no loss of lives. And last thing is the food, water and shelter. We should provide food, adequate water and shelter to the affected people. Now these are the different policies of the government. For the first time, a chapter on disaster management found place in the 10th 5-year plan, that is the 5-year plan from 2002 to 2007. Then for the first time, financial arrangement for disaster management was made in the 12th 5-year plan. So this was the last 5-year plan. After that, Niti Aayog has started. So this 12th 5-year plan was from 2012 to 2017. Then Disaster Management Act was formulated in 2005, which is considered to be a major milestone. Now disaster management policy was enacted in the year 2009. Now again in 2016, our Honorable Prime Minister of India released National Disaster Management Plan with a vision to make India disaster resilient, achieve substantial disaster risk reduction, and decrease losses of life, livelihood and assets by maximizing the ability to cope with disaster. Now next, we have again in 2009 a revised version of Disaster Management Plan 2016, incorporating comments and suggestions thereon, came into being. So this Disaster Management Plan of 2016 was again revised in 2019. Now coming to the Disaster Management Act of 2005. So this Disaster Management Act 2005 was devised in the year 2005, and it came into being following the gadget notification on 25th December 2005, exactly 1 year after the devastating tsunami in the Indian Ocean. So this particular act was framed after the 2004 Andaman Sumatra earthquake that triggered a massive tsunami in our coastline. Now this act laid down the institutional and legal framework for effective management of disasters. So there are some institutional and legal aspects of this act. And third point, the act paved way for constitution and establishment for national, state and disaster district disaster management authorities, the National Institute of Disaster Management and the National Disaster Response Force. So these are some of the organizations that were set up after this act. Envisages specific roles to be played by the local bodies in the disaster management. So they are trying to develop a concept in which the local self-government of our country should play a vital role in mitigating the disaster risk. Now coming to the National Policy on Disaster Management 2009, The National Policy on Disaster Management was approved by the Union Cabinet on 22nd October 2009, adopting a holistic or total approach in attending to all the aspects of disaster management. And this particular policy added strength to the Act of 2019. That is, please rectify this. This is 2005. This policy, that is the Disaster Management Policy 2009, added strength to the Disaster Management Act of 2005. Please rectify this. This is 2005. The policy encompasses 13 chapters, which covers every aspects of the disaster management process. So it has all total 13 chapters. Let me tell you what are these chapters. So starting with preamble, this is the simple introduction of that policy. We have approaches and objectives. We have institutional and legal arrangements, financial arrangements, disaster prevention, mitigation and preparedness, techno-legal regime, response, relief and rehabilitation. Then we have reconstruction and recovery, capacity development, knowledge management, research and development, and road ahead. So these are the 13 chapters of this policy. Now, the aim of the policy is to minimize the loss of life, livelihood and property caused both by man-made and natural disasters, and it envisions a safe and disaster resilient India through holistic and proactive strategies, and its ultimate aim is to mainstream disaster management into the development planning process. The same thing, that is, we are trying to incorporate the disaster risk reduction into the development agenda of our country. Now coming to the NPDRR, which is the National Platform for Disaster Risk Reduction. So this was formulated in the year 2013, and it is a multi-stakeholder national platform. And these are some of the members of that platform. It is chaired by the Honorable Union Home Minister. Then we have the Vice Chairman Niti Aayog. Then ministers of each state government or union territory dealing with the subject disaster management. Then we have the representatives of the local self-government and members of parliament, that is the 4 members from Lok Sabha and 2 members from the Rajya Sabha. We also have the ex-officio members, head of institutions of national importance, persons representing industry, media representatives, civil society organizations and international representatives. So these are the members of that NPDRR. Now, what is the aim of this platform? The aim of this platform is to bring together the whole range of India's disaster risk communities, starting from government, parliamentarians, local self governments, media, international organizations, various NGOs, our local community representatives, our scientific and academic institutions, and our corporate businesses. So its aim is to help in sharing of experiences, views and ideas, present findings of research and action, and explore opportunities for mutual cooperation in the field of disaster risk reduction. So by this platform, they will be able to share their experiences and views by which they can mitigate the risk of the disasters. Now coming to the question set, so these are some of the probable questions which are important from exam point of view. So the first question is, what do you mean by disaster? So I hope you must have you are now capable of understanding and defining what a disaster is. Now explain the second question is, explain the disaster management cycle briefly. Third question is, how the policies on disaster management are formulated by the policy makers of our country. Fourth question is, what are the various policies on disaster management? The fifth question is, write a short note on Disaster Management Act of 2005. So these are few questions which I hope you will answer. If there is any problem, you can, or if you have any doubt, then this is my contact information, my email ID and WhatsApp number. You can contact me. Thank you.
ଝିଅଟିଏ ତ ମାଟି ଆମ ସାମାଜିକ ଓ ପାରିବାରିକ ଜୀବନର ମୂଳ କଥାଟିଏ। ସେମାନେ ଆଗକୁ ଗଲେ ଆଗକୁ ଯିବ ସଂସାର। ଆମ ଝିଅମାନେ ଆଉ ପୁଅଙ୍କଠୁ ପଛରେ ନାହାନ୍ତି। ଏବେ ତ ବଦଳି ଗଲାଣି ସମୟ, ବଦଳି ଗଲାଣି ଯୁଗ। ସେଇ ଝିଅମାନଙ୍କୁ ଆହୁରି ଆଗକୁ ନେଇ ଆତ୍ମନିର୍ଭରଶୀଳ ଓ ସ୍ୱାବଲମ୍ବୀ କରିବାକୁ ଓଡ଼ିଶା ସରକାର ସୁଦକ୍ଷା ଯୋଜନାରେ ସରକାରୀ ITI ମାଧ୍ୟମରେ ସମ୍ପୂର୍ଣ୍ଣ ମାଗଣାରେ ଯୋଗାଇ ଦେଉଛନ୍ତି ସବୁପ୍ରକାର ଉତ୍କୃଷ୍ଟମାନର ବୈଷୟିକ ଜ୍ଞାନକୌଶଳର ତାଲିମ। ଏବେ ଆମ ଝିଅ ରହିବେ ସବୁଠୁ ଆଗରେ, ସବୁଠୁ ଉପରେ।
ମୁଁ ସଫଳ,
ମୁଁ କୁଶଳୀ,
ମୁଁ ସୁଦକ୍ଷା,
ଆମେ ହେଉଛୁ ସୁଦକ୍ଷା।